Now for the performance review, let's get right into this. Let's start with the cushion, my favorite part of the shoe. React midsole with full length zoom right underneath the foot. It's amazing. It does need breaking time, so give it time. The step in confidence is not bad at all if you want to wear this shoe casually. But once you start to run around, you'll notice that it is slightly firm. Give it a little time. You will not be disappointed. The KD 11 cushion system is epic. I love the way the React makes it to where it's not too mushy. The response time is there. And then, like I said, that full-length zoom right under the foot does not disappoint. So give it a little breaking time. You're going to love it. Let's move on. Now for the traction. The traction does not need braking time, but it will not perform the same on all court conditions. Some shoes are just that good where they can handle dusty courts. KD 11, not one of them. Clean courts, perfect. Right out of the box, you will not have any issues. And I didn't even have issues on slightly dusty courts when I had just had to wipe every now and then. But it does grab dust, so if the court is severely dusty, you will be miserable. You will not be able to play. It's just not on that top tier level handle any kind of court traction. But it's not trash either. I call it middle of the pack. Like I said, clean courts, you're going to love it. It's going to grab like crazy. You won't have any issues. And even slightly dusty courts, you'll survive. But if it's one of those 24-hour fitness, I guess. I don't have one of those in my area, but I hear they're terrible. It's one of those that doesn't get cleaned a lot. You're going to have issues. Bring a backup pair. Moving on. Nike came back with Flyknit for the materials on the KD 11. Just like they did with the 9 and the 10. And it does not disappoint. Very soft and stretchy everywhere except for the toe area where they added fuse for durability. But right around that ankle area, very soft and stretchy. And you have no issues getting this shoe on. Maybe once or twice, but definitely after pulling it open with that pull tab in the back a couple of times, you should not have any issues. So it's not a very tough shoe to get on. And the materials are nice. I do think they could have moved that sturdier toe box area to the lateral side to help, but I'll get into that on the next topic. But for the most part, you just get a nice, comfortable ride with Flyknit as usual with the KD line. No break-in time needed. Materials are A1. Now for supporting lockdown. The overall containment on the KD 11 is poor. I wanted to play in the same pair because I did read where Nike said your foot is supposed to start to sink into that mid-toe cup area for added support. And the more I played in these, it did improve, but still not to where it should be. And you shouldn't have to play in a shoe that long to start to feel safe, especially on lateral movements. That's why I was saying in my last segment about the materials there to move that sturdier toe box area to the side. Maybe that would have helped, but who knows? They just should have figured out a way to get your foot locked in better, because on hard stops, cuts, crossovers where you have to plant going back left to right, that's where you have the most issues. You just feel like you're gonna roll over almost every time. And for me, this shoe fits me so well, lengthwise and widthwise. I'm still able to play in this shoe, but I'm giving an overall, honest opinion. I had a buddy of mine playing in the same exact shoe 2 or 3 days in a row on the same court as me. He had all kind of issues with containment. So the issues are definitely there. I cannot give the containment a good score at all. It just needs improvement all the way around. You just don't feel safe, and if you don't feel safe, you can't play to your full potential. Now, as far as heel slip goes, I experienced none of that at all. Not once did I have heel slip. From the first time I put them on to the 30th time I put them on, heel slip was perfect. You're locked in that way. But overall containment just should have been better. So to wrap up the performance review for the KD 11 at $150, do I recommend it for basketball purposes? No, I just cannot. But It's a comfortable shoe, and I love the way they look. I love the colorways that's dropping. And for me personally, the way they fit me and the things that I look for in a basketball shoe, I'm going to continue to play in the KD 11 for now. I really enjoy the shoe on and off court, but my honest opinion, what I experienced at first and from what people close to me experienced throughout their play in the shoe, I just cannot recommend it for anyone. Thank you guys for watching. Thanks for the continued support on YouTube, on Instagram. I truly appreciate it. Until next time, peace.